Welcome students, you are watching the video lecturer class of Udayanath Autonomous College of Science and Technology. I am Pratichi Das, lecturer in MCom Finance and Control. So today our topic is Principles of Management. Let's start about the topic. So what is management? Let's start about the introduction of management. Management is an important element in every organization. It is the element that coordinates current organizational activity and plans for the future. So management is an important element in every organization. So organization is a place where a group of people working together for achieving a single objective or single goal. So management is an important element in every organization which coordinates all organizational activities and plan for the future activity of that particular organization. The management adapts the organization to its environment and shapes the organization to make it more suitable to the organization. So management adapts or the organizational environment and shape that particular organization for more suitable organization. So management plays an important role in every organization. Let's start about the definition of management. According to F.W. Taylor, art of knowing what you want to do and the seeing that it is done the best and cheapest way. So F.W. Taylor defined management that management is an art of knowing what you want to do. That means what the organization want to do and seeing that that work is properly done or not, or that work is done the best or not, and that work is done with a cheapest way or not. So that is known as our management according to F.W. Taylor. According to Henry Fayol, management is defined as to manage is to forecast, to plan, to organize, to command, to coordinate, and to control. So Henry Fayol defined that management means to forecast, to plan, to organize, to command, to coordinate, and to control. According to Peter F. Drucker, management is work and as such it has its own skills, its own tools and its own technique. So management is work according to Peter F. Drucker, and management has its own skills, it has own tools and its own technique is there. So overall, management is defined as management is the art of getting things done through and with people. So management is art of getting the work or getting the things done through the people and with the people. So that is known as our management. Different contexts of defining management are: the management is defined according to the different context and that are known as our management process. So that context are production oriented, decision oriented, people oriented and function oriented. So management is defined according to different context. So let's start about that context. First one is the production oriented. What is production oriented management? Production oriented management is defined as management is the art of knowing what you want to do and then seeing that it is done in the best and cheapest way. So production oriented management is otherwise known as our efficiency oriented management. So it is an art of knowing what the organization want to do and seeing that work is done in the best and cheapest way or not. So another context of defining management is decision oriented management. So according to the decision-oriented management, management is defined as management is simply the process of decision-making and control over the action of human beings for the expressed purpose of attaining predetermined goals. So decision-oriented management is a process of decision-making and control over the action of human beings for the purpose of attaining or getting the predetermined goals by the organization. Another context of defining management is people-oriented management. So what is people-oriented management? People-oriented management is the accomplishment of results through the efforts of other people. That means this management process focuses on the results through which other people were working for achieving that particular objective or particular result. And what is function-oriented management? The function-oriented management is to manage, is to forecast and to plan, to organize, to coordinate and to control. So function-oriented management is defined as forecasting, planning, organizing, coordinating and controlling basis. What are the importance of management? The importance of management may be defined as effective utilization of resources, development of resources, to incorporate innovations, integrating various interest groups, and stability in the society. So, importance of management plays very important process in management. So what are the importance? The first importance is effective utilization of resources. Every organization has different types of resources. So that resources needed a effective utilization so that the organization can earn or achieve the particular objective. For achieving that objective, utilization of resources is necessary. So how the resources can be effectively utilized? A proper management process or a proper effective management process. So that is an importance of management, that effective utilization of resources. Another importance is development of resources. As we know, different resources are there in the organization. So it is necessary to develop that resources for achieving the organizational goal or organizational objective. And that could be done only through an effective management. So that is an other importance of management, that is development of resources. Another resources or another importance is known as our incorporate innovation. That means the corporate innovations can be done through on the basis of managerial activity. As the managerial activities are playing different role in an organization, so incorporate innovations can be based on the managerial activity. And it is another importance of management. Next importance of management is integrating various interest groups and stability in the society. With the organization, different groups are attached and they have different types of interest. So they are known as our stakeholders. So those interest groups may be internal groups or maybe the external groups. So integrating that various groups, it is an activity of a management, and that can be done through a proper managerial activity or proper management activity. So it is an importance of management. Another importance is stability in the society. So every organization wants to stabilize in the society. So it is necessary for the management, or it is necessary to the activity of the management, that organization can stable and build up its image in the society. So that is the last importance of management, that is known as our stability in the society. Let's start about the management functions or the process of management. So management functions are defined according to different authors. Those are known as our Newman and Sommer. According to Newman and Sommer, the management function is defined as planning, organizing, leading and controlling. So the management function or management process based on planning, organizing, leading and controlling according to Newman and Sommer. According to Henry Fayol, the management function is defined as planning, organizing, commanding, coordinating and controlling. According to Luther Gulick, the management is defined as post-corp. So P for planning, O for organizing, S for staffing, D for directing, coordinating, R for reporting and B for budgeting. According to Joseph Massey, the management function is defined as decision making, organizing, staffing, planning, controlling, communicating and directing. According to Coons O'Donnell, organizational process or management function is defined as planning, organizing, staffing, directing and controlling. So these are the process of management function or management process. So let's start about the functions of management. The functions of management, as we discussed above, that they are defining as planning, organizing, staffing, directing, coordinating, controlling, reporting and budgeting. So first function of management is planning. So let's start about what is planning. Planning is a process of deciding the business objectives and charting out the plan method for achieving the same. So planning is a process of deciding the objective of the business, what the business is actually want to achieve, what is the objective of that particular organization. That can be done through a proper planning process and charting out that plan or method for achieving that particular objective. So planning includes determination of what is to be done, how and where is to be done, who will do it and how results are to be evaluated. So planning process involves what, how, where, who and how. So what is to be done in the organization, how is to be done, where is to be done and who will do it and how the result will be evaluated through that particular activity, and that is known as our planning process or planning function of management. So this function expected to be carried out throughout the organization. It should be performed by the manager at all level. So this planning function is expected to be carried out throughout the organization. That means all the activity or what type of activities are done between the organization or overall activity of the organization can be done through a planning function. And it should be performed by the manager at all level. As different types of managers are there and different levels of managers are there between the organization, so planning function is performed by at all level of managers. After the planning function or planning process, next function of management is organizing. According to Allen, the organizing refers to the structure which results from identifying and grouping the work, defining and delegating responsibility and authority, and establishing the relationship. So according to Allen, organizing is defined as it is a structure through which results can be identified, and grouping that result with a work, and defining and delegating the responsibility and authority, and establishing the relationship. That means the result can be identified or the objective can be identified, and that objective can be grouped with the work between the people, and defining how the responsibility can be delegated, and defining delegating responsibility and authority, and establishing the relationship between the organization. organize a business is to provide it with everything useful to its functioning. That is, personnel, raw material, machinery, capital, etc. So, to organize a business or organize the business activity or organizing the activity between the organization, it provides everything useful to its functioning. That means how the organization can function with a useful process. So that can be defined as personnel, that means men, the raw material or material, machinery, and capital means money. That means four aims are playing a various or important role in the organizational activity, and that is known as our organizing. That is men, material, machinery, and money. Once objectives are established, manager has to develop plan to achieve them with help of human resources as well as material resources. So when an objective is established, then manager can develop plan to achieve that particular objective, and that objective can be achieved with the help of human resources as well as material resources, and that is known as our organizing or organizing process of management or the functions of management. So another function of management is known as our directing. Directing involves communication, leadership, and motivation. That means direction or directing has three elements that are known as our communication process, leadership process, and motivation. So communication is the process of passing the information and understanding it from one person to the another person. That means communicating the language from one person to the another person. That means what language the information can be communicated or the information can be passed from one person to the another person, and that information can be understood easily by the person. So that is known as our communication process. So what is leadership? Leadership is the function whereby the person or manager guides and influences the work of his subordinate. So every manager has different number of subordinates are there. So manager plays a leadership role in an organization. So leadership is a function where a person or manager guides and influences the work of its subordinates. So another content of directing is our motivation. So what is motivation? Motivation is to motivate the employees to give their best to the organization. So it is the duty or activity of a manager that he will motivate the employee or he will motivate the subordinates to give their best, through which the organization can achieve its objectives. Another function is known as our controlling. The controlling involves establishing standards of performance, measuring current performance and comparing it against the established standard, taking corrective action that does not meet the standard, and control compels the events to conform to plan. So controlling process involves these four steps, that is establishing standards of performance, measuring current performance, taking corrective action, and control compels and conforms to the plans. So another function is known as our innovation and representation. This is the last process of management, that is innovation and representation. These are also two important additional managerial functions. So that means before, as we have discussed about different function or process of management, there we have discussed that the function defined as planning, organizing, staffing, directing, coordinating, and controlling. So these are the new process or new function of management, that is known as our innovations and representation. So what is innovation? Innovation means creating new ideas which may either result in the development of new products or finding new uses for older ones. and it is necessary to grow better. So innovation means creating new ideas through which the development of new products can be done and finding new uses of the older ones. That means what is the existing product is there, what are the new uses of that particular existing product, that is known as our innovation. And what is representation? The manager has to represent himself for the organization. A manager must win support effectively from different groups. Either they may be internal groups or they may be external groups. So manager plays an important role and it has to represent himself for the organization, for the organizational activity. As the goal of the organization is set by the manager and as the goal of the organization or objective of the organization is important for the manager, therefore manager has to represent himself for the organization and that manager must win support effectively from different groups. That as we have discussed about different groups, like internal groups are there and external groups are there who have some interest with the organization and they can support the manager to represent himself for the organization. So keep watching. Thank you.